Shalom, friends. Robert Gottslick here from the Friends of Israel Gospel Ministry. The last time we got together, we started the 9th chapter of the book of Zechariah. And there I talked about Alexander the Great and the cities that he was conquering on his way to Egypt. And there we looked at that prophecy in Zechariah of Tyre. We also looked at the prophecy of Tyre in Ezekiel 26 and 27. And if you haven't watched that sermon by video from the last time, I just encourage your friends to go back and to watch that. We had a fantastic study. It's an amazing prophecy of Tyre. And speaking of Alexander the Great, and so, you know, I know you'll be blessed by it. But we also saw that God made a promise in verse 8 of the 9th chapter of Zechariah that he would spare Jerusalem. And that's one for the history books, because Alexander the Great did not conquer Jerusalem. God indeed did spare Jerusalem. And so this week in our study, I'm going to begin by rereading verse 8. And so, like always, if you have your Bibles handy, just turn with me to Zechariah chapter 9 and verse 8. And God says, "And I will encamp about mine house because of the army," speaking of Alexander the Great's army, "because of him that passeth by and because of him that returneth." Now, I'm just going to stop there in the middle of the verse, because that was the promise God made, and that indeed happened. As I mentioned, that's one for the history books. God did spare Jerusalem from Alexander the Great. But look at the second part of the verse, because that's yet to come to pass. Because God says, "And no oppressor shall pass through them any more," speaking of his land coming against the Jerusalem and against the people. No oppressor is going to do that anymore, "for now I have seen with my eyes." And we're going to see just exactly what God has seen, because we're going to pick that up in verse 9 here in a moment. But I just want to say this, that the reason that that verse has not come to pass yet, that second part of that verse, is because we still see Jerusalem being trodden down by the Gentiles. Time of the Gentiles began in 586 BC, when King Nebuchadnezzar came in and destroyed the first temple, and God's people were scattered 350 miles to the east in Babylon. So the time of the Gentiles began there. And even though Alexander the Great didn't conquer Jerusalem, there were many oppressors that came upon Jerusalem. Look at Antiochus Epiphanes that came after Alexander the Great. He persecuted the Jewish people and he oppressed Jerusalem. I think of the Romans. They destroyed the second temple in 70 AD. They afflicted God's people. You know, then along came the Crusaders, and then along came the Muslims. And even up to this present day, Jerusalem is trodden down by the Gentiles. And that's exactly what Jesus said in Luke 21. He says that Jerusalem would be trodden down by the Gentiles until the time of the Gentiles be fulfilled. And so the time of the Gentiles started in 586 BC and will continue all the way up to the end of the time of Jacob's trouble, to the end of that 7-year tribulation period when Jesus, the Messiah, returns. And then the focus will shift back onto the Jewish people. And we'll talk about that here in a moment. But God's got his eyes fixed on something when the second part of that verse is going to come to fulfillment, because he has his eyes fixed upon the Messiah in the very next verse, that his eyes fixed on his only begotten son, Yeshua, Jesus. And look at verse 9. "Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout, O daughter of Jerusalem. Behold, thy king cometh unto thee. He is just and having salvation, lowly and riding upon an ass and upon a colt, the foal of an ass." This is depictant of when Jesus came riding in on that colt. What we as Christians celebrate is Palm Sunday. Jesus came in and riding there. And it was prophesied here in Zechariah 500 years before it came to pass. Zechariah wrote this 2,500 years ago. It's amazing. It's an amazing. And you know, you can read about it in the New Testament here, Matthew 21 and John chapter 12 and Luke chapter 19. You know, and when Jesus came riding in there in Luke 19, and his disciples were cheering, and what did the Pharisees, they say, "Jesus, you tell your disciples to be quiet." And Jesus says, "I tell you that if they should keep their peace, if they should be silent, even the stones themselves would shout." You know, and then we see that Jesus, he weeps over Jerusalem. Because why? Because the people did not know the time of his visitation. How would they know that? Well, Zechariah wrote about it 500 years before it came to pass. But there's even a greater prophecy, and it's by the prophet Daniel. The angel Gabriel gave Daniel an incredible prophecy that he actually prophesied the exact day that Jesus would come in on that colt. And look, if you will, if you have your Bibles, to Daniel chapter 9 here, because in the 25th verse here, the angel Gabriel tells Daniel, he says, "Know therefore and understand that from the going forth of the command to," now remember this, "restore and build Jerusalem," okay, we'll talk about that decree, unto Messiah the Prince shall be 7 weeks, 62 weeks. In other words, 69 weeks of years. It says the street shall be built again and the wall even in troublesome times. Troublous times. And of course, when you come to the book of Nehemiah, we see exactly the trouble that that the people faced trying to rebuild the wall, try to rebuild Jerusalem. Now, there was a decree given to rebuild the temple as the returnees were making their way back to Jerusalem from Babylon. And there was a decree given in Ezra chapter 1 by the Persian king Cyrus. But that decree was to rebuild the temple. Here we come to Nehemiah chapter 2. And this decree is by the Persian king Artaxerxes I. And he gives that decree to rebuild and restore Jerusalem. And that's what Daniel's talking about in the 25th verse. The decree to restore and rebuild Jerusalem unto Messiah the Prince would be 69 weeks of years. Now, what's a week of year? Well, a week of year is a 7-year period of time. In Genesis chapter 29, speaking of Jacob, of course, we know what happened with Leah and Rachel, but Jacob had to serve his uncle Laban another 7 years. And in the 29th chapter in verse 27, it says, "Fulfill her week," Laban says, "and I will give thee this also for the service which thou serve with me yet another 7 years." And so Jacob did do that. He fulfilled her week. That 7 years, he had to serve Laban another 7 years for Rachel. That was a week of year. And so 69 weeks of years, I'm going to turn here for a moment, turn to Nehemiah chapter 2. Because the decree here in chapter 2 here, it gives us a date here. It says, "And it came to pass in the month of Nisan," this is the verse 1, chapter 2, "in the 20th year reign of Artaxerxes the king." Okay? You go to your encyclopedia, to your history books, friends, you're going to see that Artaxerxes the first was the king of Persia, and he ruled from 464 to 425 BC. But in his 20th year reign, it was March 14th, 445 BC. Artaxerxes launched Emmaus, and he gives the decree in that year to restore and rebuild Jerusalem. Well, you take from 445 BC, March 14th, and you take 173,880 days. Now, why do I say that? Why do I say that many days? Because it was 69 weeks of years, right? A week of year, 7 years. Well, you times 69 by 7, you come up with 483 years. Now, how many days are in a biblical year? 360. Times 483 by 360, you get 173,880 days to the day that Jesus rode in on that colt. And the scholars have pinpointed that day to April 6th, 32 AD on the 10th of Nisan. Wow, that's amazing. No wonder Jesus said that if my disciples should hold their peace to be quiet, even the stones themselves would shout, because that day was prophesied. And it's an incredible prophecy. And not only that, maybe you're saying to yourself, "Well, Rob, yeah, that's a pretty specific dates, and I don't quite agree with those because there's other scholars that have different dates, plus or minus 5 years, plus or minus 10 years. Do you have another candidate that was prophesied to be the Messiah that would come riding in on that donkey, that colt, prophesied by Daniel and by Zechariah, that later Daniel says in the 26th verse of the 9th chapter, Messiah would be cut off? Do you have another candidate that was cut off? That wrote, we don't, do we? Wow, God's word's true. God's word is true, friends. This book is not like the religious writings of the world. None dare to predict the future. Only God's word, and it's incredible. And so Zechariah chapter 9 here, he tells the people to rejoice. They were supposed to rejoice then. This is bringing comfort to the returnees too. As they're reading this, of course, it didn't happen in their day. It happened 2,000 years ago. What we celebrate, as I mentioned, on Palm Sunday here. But the people at that time in 32 AD, they were supposed to rejoice. They were supposed to shout, their king, here's their king. Remember when Jesus came, he was offering him the kingdom. Here it is. You want the kingdom? Here it is. Oh, but friends, we owe the Jewish people so much. Why? And why do we owe the Jewish people so much? We owe the Jewish people so much because Paul tells us in Romans 11, their rejection of Jesus' salvation has come unto the Gentiles. So we owe the Jewish people lots. We owe them lots. And so it's an incredible prophecy here in the 9th verse here. But look at verse 10 here, because that's speaking of his second coming here. And we don't have much time to look at that here today here. But this is what it says here. I will cut off the chariot from Ephraim and the horse from Jerusalem. And so Israel and Judah here. And it says, and the battle bow shall be cut off. God's going to destroy Israel's enemies. And he shall speak peace unto the heathen, unto the nations. This is depicted of when Messiah will set up his millennial reign here. And his dominion shall be from sea to sea and from the river even to the ends of the earth. And so it's coming a time here in the millennial kingdom at the when Yeshua returns at his second coming. That's what verse 10 is talking about. And we're going to talk more about that next week because that's all the time we have for today. So friends, if you enjoyed this video on my Facebook page or YouTube channel, just give it a like and share it with all your friends. And so until next time, Shalom.